No, really. It's Bobby Hull Jr. Listen, I want to ask you a question. What has Scotty done to Brett to make him such a great hockey player?
Well, I think Scotty Bowman isn't afraid of Brett. He's not intimidated. And he's let Brett do a lot more than any of the other NHL coaches in his career have let him do. He's killing penalties. He's playing special teams all the time. And Brett's playing with a lot more confidence as a result of that. So he and Scotty are thinking the same way.
Well, I tell you, he's really got it going. And I'll tell you something. Nobody's playing like him. He leads the NHL in goals. Terrific. Your dad was a good breeder, Bobby. All right, back to you.
What's your score? I'll just ask you that, Bobby.
I'll tell you what. If Carolina comes out and scores the first goal, I think it's going to be 2-1 for the Red Wings. If the Wings get the first goal, I think it's going to be 4-1 for the Red Wings tonight. So I'm all Red Wings tonight.
That's your duty, right?
Well, good for Brett and Bobby. Great to have you aboard. Like Mike Eiserman, Stevie's older brother, great Dal Brett. Quick thought on the game, Don.
Well, I'll tell you, Detroit doesn't like those 2 days off, that's for sure. They might have lost that edge, as they were saying. But Carolina's got to come out. They got to come out, stop the trap, get some offense, get their speed going. They cannot play the trap forever. What they're doing now, hoping they don't lose, they got to come out, win the game, play to win. That's the only way.
Teams are coming on the ice here shortly. We're going to move aside for a little rock and roll, little kiss to kick things off here as we tune up for game 5.
Stanley Cup Playoffs on Hockey Night in Canada. Brought to you by Labatt Blue, official sponsor of the Stanley Cup Playoffs.
Come to Lover's Paradise. Hold hands, skip along the beach. Get in touch with love.
You call that a trip? The Ultimate Bud World Experience. That's a trip. Find the winning Ultimate Bud World Experience Passport in specially marked cases of Budweiser, and you and 3 buddies are off to 3 of these unbelievable sporting weekends. Must be at least 21 years of age, no purchase necessary.
It's the best-selling line of pickup trucks in Canada. It's the best-selling truck in the U.S. In fact, F-Series is the best-selling truck in the world. If you're not driving the truck more people in the world depend on, maybe it's time you did.
This portion of Hockey Night in Canada, brought to you by Ford of Canada, Canada's number one choice.
You'll never convince these folks it's not a fait accompli.
10 cups tonight. Yeah. Let them see red.
Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. It was a cool day today, so the ice conditions are ideal for this fifth game. Yuri Slager, think of the pressure on him. In for Yuri Fischer tonight. Fischer suspended for one game for the cross check late in game number four. That's the only wrinkle. Detroit's been a scoring machine, 69 goals. Carolina just 46. Our two Scots will give us some of the keys to this fifth game, beginning with Scott Russell, who will be joined by Freddie Olesen. Scott?
Well, Ron, the Red Wings have the wonderful advantage of being able to renew themselves every year. That is to say, they add players to their lineup to keep themselves as contenders. And right now, a Fab Four of acquisitions has the Wings on the verge of a Stanley Cup, approaching game number five, all making a contribution. Dominic Hasek has six shutouts to lead the NHL in the postseason. That's a record. Brett Hull has 10 goals. That leads the league in the playoffs. Luke Robitaille, a big game seven versus Colorado with 3 points. And Frederik Olesen, the defenseman, had an overtime winner versus the Avs. Here's Frederik Olesen, 15 years in this league, Frederik, still without the Stanley Cup. I wonder if you can give us an idea of the anticipation about tonight.
Well, the anticipation for us is just to go out and play a great game. We try not to get ahead of ourselves and think that we're winning the cup at the moment.
What has the experience been like for you to play with a defenseman of the stature of Nick Lidstrom?
Well, he's an outstanding defenseman, maybe the best in the world. And, he's such a calm influence on every player that he plays with.
Good luck to you, Frederik, in this game number five.
Thank you very much.
Frederik Olesen of the Red Wings, now over to Scott Oak in the Carolina hallway.
Scott, thanks very much. Tonight we haul out one of the oldest axioms in sport, and that is you can't win if you can't score. And that's why the Carolina Hurricanes face elimination tonight. They haven't scored in the Stanley Cup final in over 127 minutes. It would really help if any of these five or a combination thereof could get going. Then the Canes would have a chance to spoil the Wings party tonight. Here's Marty Jelena. Marty, tough to score, obviously, in the Stanley Cup final. What has been the problem?
Well, they've been playing well defensively. There's no question about it. I think not enough people give credit to the Wings for their defensive game. They've been playing outstanding, and Hasek has been playing a big role for those guys. He also subbed the puck, but he plays the puck very well. So we got to find a way to get around those guys and put more pucks on that, and hopefully the rebounds, and we'll have more chances.
1994, you remember the Vancouver Canucks, and you made the walk to Madison Square Garden for Game 5 of the Stanley Cup Final, and you could see everybody there was getting ready to party, and you spoiled the party on the Rangers. How much motivation do you draw from the prospect of ruining the party?
You know, I remember in 94, I was walking to the rink with Dave Babich, and it must have been 200 policemen and horses ready for the big party and the riot after the game, and we got there, we played a great game, came out on top, and that changed the momentum of the series. So I think that the motivation is in the room. I think there's enough leaders in the room to make it happen. I think we're ready.
Marty, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Ron, back to you.
Scott, thank you. Standing by for the Star Spangled Banner.
The Red Wings' own Karen Newman.
Oh, see, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright
say, does this star-spangled banner
first time in the 2002 playoffs, the Stanley Cup is in the building. So you know what's at stake as we get set for game five. To the booth we go. Bob Cole, Harry Neal, Robert.
Good evening again, everybody. Yep, it's game five, all right. And everybody around this area will tell you this is the last game of these playoffs. Carolina, I'm sure, have other ideas in mind tonight. One of them is Artur Zerbe. He has a 5-1 record on the road in the last six starts with a 144 goals against average and 947 save percentage. Dominic Hasek recorded his sixth shutout in these playoffs. That's a record in game four. 122 goals against average in this series. This is Steve Walkham with him, Bill McCreary, the two referees, Brad Lazarowicz and Brian Murphy will be the two linesmen. And the starting lineups for Scotty Bowman, he's with Olsson and Lidstrom. Iserman and Fedorov with Shanahan up front. Paul Maurice starting Hedekin and Ward, O'Neill, Francis and Svoboda. We are underway in game five. Into the Detroit zone first off. Olsson turns. Svoboda sliding into the boards as he missed him with a check. Down through center. Lidstrom firing the shot on. Big rebound was set up. It was covered though for Urbe. And O'Neill shot the puck to center. Svoboda didn't see it up behind him. Francis was turning to go off. Nearly a break by Fedorov. Stopped just in time. Played through center ice. Detroit on it. Long shot into the glove of Urbe. Only two shots so far by the Red Wings. Fair distance both. Caroline up as far as the Detroit line. Going in was Cole and he was dumped. That far side was Battaglia, didn't stop the puck, it came out, play goes offside.
Yuri Slager's playing his first game of these playoffs because of the suspension to Fisher, and early in his first game, he's challenged by Cole to the outside. But you can see, like most of the Detroit left defensemen, they take away the boards on Cole, and he has had a tough time getting to the net. Slager played 46 games this year after 3 goals, 6 assists for 9 points, was acquired from Atlanta just before the deadline for Batsayev and a third round pick. I'm sure his father, Yuri Bubla in Vancouver, is watching with pride tonight.
Face off, won by Carolina. A little shot was in wide of the net. They're coming after it though, forechecking hard. It goes to the corner around the net. Vasilchuk with a hit on Dandino. In front of the goal, here's a shot by Kapanen, is blocked. And Hasek will slow the play by hanging on to this.
Sammy Kapanen, who's in an awful slump, gets an early chance to score in this game and forces Dominic Hasek to make a good save. As the puck was turned over halfway out of the Red Wing zone, Kapanen shoots about a 32-footer, but can't beat Hasek. Low to the left side. Hasek's a tough goalie to beat if you don't get it up.
And he's tough then. Setting a record for shutouts in these playoffs. Hasek looking for his first Stanley Cup. Carolina back. Vasilchuk will come back. He'll watch his defenseman Sean Hill play it around the net. Kapanen had to move up. Didn't get away on it, and the shot is just wide of the net. Kapanen a little bit of sleep on that one and rolled right out in front of him. He didn't move. Duchesne tries a shot. That's knocked down in front, and now Urbe will glove that and hang on.
Well, it looks like Paul Maurice has made changes in all four of his lines. The first two were lines he's not used in this playoff. I think it's a great move. First of all, it'll heighten the concentration of the players who play with new line mate. And secondly, they haven't scored in a long time, so why go with the same line? A nice coaching decision by Paul Maurice. We'll see if it works.
Troyd winning this faceoff, and Lidstrom again. Doesn't shoot at the net this time, just dumped it in behind the goal. Troyd player knocked down. He goes right on, and Detroit takes the puck in center ice. Here they come. Holmstrom shot into the glove of Urbe. What a chance that was. He might have gone a step or two more, but he elected to take the shot.
Well, you can see that part of the Red Wings' strategy is get some shots on Urbe early, even if they aren't real quality scoring chances. This isn't a bad one from the top of the circle. But the first goal is such a dynamic stat in these playoffs. If Carolina scores, they're 9-2. If the Red Wings score, they're 11-2.
Four shots already on this man. Kapanen has the only shot for Carolina. Lidstrom kept it in. Hull shot it at the net. Knocked down. Wallin around the goal and coming out. Hull in the forecheck, but it got by. And at the line, Carolina bring it out. O'Neill got as far as center and then fell. Hasek out again. Dumped it away to the boards on the right side. Olsson shot it behind the net for Lidstrom, his defense partner. They get the puck to the line and not out. Svoboda lost it though. Down through center, Datsyuk nearly got away. Carolina Hurricanes pump it in again. From the corner, cleared up on the boards, all right, and out. Stopped though in the center ice area. And Aaron Moore ahead with Cole coming over the line. Bring the Moore, shot the puck. Cole was open, might have gone to him. Taglia back to the point. Missed at the blue line by Hennigan. And he'll stride back. Look at him go. Beautiful stride on Brett Hennigan. Cleared out to the blue line. They don't move it out right away, and Yzerman waits. Not long enough. Offside called against Detroit.
Well, there's a pile of forwards who haven't scored in a long time in these playoffs, and Eric Cole and Battaglia are two players with Brind'Amour who really led this team down the road in the first two rounds. Brind'Amour is the only one that scored since round two.
Nearing 4 minutes of the first in game five. Detroit with three wins. Carolina won the first game in overtime. Center ice. Knocked in over the line. Slager is number 71, made the first play on it. And he'll come to center with Shanahan on the far side. The shot is blocked. And it bounces out over the blue line again. Fedorov steered it back. Lifts it high. Yzerman waited long enough this time. Then he was dumped on the boards just inside the blue line. He's okay, stays on. Hoping the puck will come back to him. It does, usually does. Shot it to the corner. Now he has to chase Vasilchuk. Big Vasilchuk shot it away across the blue line. And Detroit easily picking it up. Slamming it back in was Malpe. Urbe out of the net, stopping it. Right in front of the goal, the pass. Vasilchuk got it up the center. Carolina in. And the drive is off a stick and wide. And Westman comes up after it along with Zelenov. Over on the boards. Red Wings shoot it down the ice and no icing. So Malik has to hurry back. Dangerous pass up through the middle. Got the crowd ooing and awing on that. Great knowledgeable crowd, of course, here in what they call Hockey Town, Detroit, USA. Red Wings looking for their 10th Stanley Cup tonight. Nearing 5 minutes of the first and no score to report yet. Shot in and Adams racing up for Carolina. He doesn't get there. It's touched up and it's icing against the Hurricanes.
Well, Duchesne is one of those old-timers who's played a pile of games in the National Hockey League, as Robitaille, Olsson, and Hasek are in the same category, and they have not been able to get their autograph on the Stanley Cup. Are they going to tonight? The excitement of that possibility must be very difficult to contain, especially if you're one of these four Cowboys.
Marjanov is on again, winning faceoffs for Detroit. Long shot. Face off in the zone as that's knifed up over the glass by Urbe to his left.
Well, Artur Urbe is the only reason that this series isn't over. His teammates have not given him any kind of a cushion as far as a goal or two is concerned. So his stats are terrific for a goalie who's only won one game in this series. He practices every day shooting that puck through the hole in the glass. Maybe his forward should work at that a little more.
As the game goes on and there is no score, you would think, Harry, that the Carolina Hurricanes would get more and more confidence. Coming into this game, they have to be down, playing away from home here in Detroit. The crowd expecting you-know-what. Ready to honor, jump. Well, the Red Wings are starting up through center. Pax gets up to the blue line, all right, and they're all back there to break it up. O'Neill turns, fires it down the ice. Hurricanes come up for it. O'Neill over in front of the net, won't get a chance to play it as Robitaille is down. Gets over the line, the pass was a good one, right in on goal. On and roll by the far side. Another shot, all off the goalpost. Detroit coming close. The first rush, Robitaille, what a pass. And Irvin made the save and didn't get all of it. And the roll and rolled and nearly went in. Then it did come out and they nailed the goalpost. I guess you would laugh.
Well, Robitaille, who makes the initial pass on this rush that was a 3-on-2. Here's the good chance that rolled between the legs of Verbe, but not in. And then Larionov, who can find a guy in the clear as well as anybody in this game, finds a Red Wing teammate in the slot, and he hits the post. Here's the one that trickled through the legs of Verbe.
Still no score, 5 seconds shy of the six-minute mark of the first. Carolina have had just the one shot so far. Detroit has had six and that goalpost. So it's scoreless so far in the first.
A long weekend in June yet, but don't let that stop you. Blue Light declares June 14th free day. Go to freeyourtime.ca to find a party near you. Must be legal drinking age.
Tonight, some lucky fan will get to go one-on-one with Tracy Reynolds for $1,000.
I got the ticket.
Now,
like Mike.
A kid with something to prove is taking his game to a whole new level.
Whoa! I guess this would be a bad time for me to ask you for your autograph, huh?
July 3rd, make your move.
I got dogs bigger than that in my house.
And play like Mike. July 3rd, only in theaters.
Your Metro Detroit Ford dealers have 5 of the 10 best sellers in America, making us America's number one choice for 15 years straight. Now, ACD plan lessees can lease Taurus for $199 a month with $1,899 to its signing. Taurus comes with a V6, power moonroof, adjustable pedals, and more. With all this, the competition better watch out, cuz. See your Metro Detroit Ford dealer now.
Robitaille was the architect of the first real good scoring chance as Olsson joins the rush and gets this shot that nearly trickles in. And then Robitaille, he goes to the front of the net where he knows where to go and gets a quick wrister away off the post.
Now from center. Ball being given away. Datsyuk set it up over the blue line, but Cole tipped it out again to center ice. Brindamore fires one in off the boards. Taglia was up there, couldn't get there in time. Now Taglia in on the boards. Kelly was watching him. Carolina putting the heat on a little bit here against Detroit. Out in front, center pass off a skate and wide of the net. Centered again, and Hushik stopped that pass out. And the puck was lifted off the glass and down the ice. It doesn't reach the icing line. And that's Malik. Not a good pass for Wallin to handle. He had to stop to pick it up. Malik now had to hurry. Shot at the center. Detroit will intercept it right there in front of the line. And Duchesne passed it back. This is Shanahan with Iserman and Fedorov coming in. Verbe played it himself to the line. O'Neill shot it to center. Carolina moving up on it. Svoboda dropped it back. And it's picked off by Fedorov. He got rid of it. Hill back to the goal. No score. 7:15 gone in the first of game 5. Through center. Pretty good looking rush here. But That move at the blue line by Wesley put three people offside.
What a great display of leadership by Captain Steve Yzerman, who needs knee surgery in the offseason, told me yesterday that it will be about a six-month rehab, and he doesn't know when he'll be back. One of the greatest sources of energy is pride when you are doing as well as Yzerman, and he's got this team by the throat, pulling him toward the Stanley Cup.
Just will not quit, no matter what pain has to withstand. Some games he could hardly get up once he was down. Scramble back to his knees, back to his feet, then barely could move. Next thing you know, he's on a break setting somebody up.
He hasn't practiced since the playoffs started. And when they have 2 days off, he doesn't like it because it means 2 days with no skating for him. And he'd rather have the 1 day off and then get right back at it.
Marvelous player. 7:27 gone in the first. No score. Duchesne and Shanahan. Troy taking off and getting the puck over the line again. Dumped in front of the net. Power almost up there. So was Shanahan. It went high over Yzerman's head and down the ice. Dandino got back. Yzerman made a quick pass. Shanahan took it on a skate. Now they move it in. It is Duchesne giving it. Yzerman shot is high over the net. Chance to move it deep. And Danino fires it back in for Detroit. They're changing. Carolina move it to center. Three of them are up there and they move on. Shot in by Kapanen. He was bumped then when he shot that one in. He couldn't move on. Red Wings don't get it out. Shot is low and wide into the net. Cleared down the ice. Janina broke his stick, had to go off. This is icing against the Red Wings. 8:27 gone, no score, shot 6-1, Detroit.
Well, you can count on the fact that Paul Maurice is not going to revolutionize his team's game plan. This is their 106th game of the season and their 23rd playoff game, and they're still alive in the finals. You might shuffle the deck as far as players are concerned, but you're not going to shuffle the strategy that got you here. Not much anyway. I know they need goals, but they win a lot of games because they don't give you any.
As we were saying earlier, the longer they stay close and the longer they stay like they are now, no score, they're dangerous, very dangerous. Seems like they've gone on forever in these playoffs, just like this. One goal lead, tie game, one goal down. Here's a two-on-one. Slager well behind him. He had to slow to get it and then couldn't move. Adams is forechecking for Carolina. Open ice pass. Knocked down through center ice. Adams comes in. Gets a backhander away. Not much on that. Rolled off the heel of a stick and Detroit cleared out. Hardy got it up there. They go to center. Hardy into the zone. Maltby ran into the linesman and couldn't go very far. Detroit back to regroup. Mark of the first coming up. Still no score. Red Wings don't get it away cleanly. Holmstrom has stopped. Two checkers on him. Pataglia rolled it loose and comes after it. Gets it over the line. His pass hit a skate and bounced back to center ice. Only takes the second pass. Moves up there across center. Tried to shoot it in. It's deflected over the glass again into the crowd.
Igor Larionov has a two-game point streak going with three goals in his last two games, including, of course, the overtime winner in that long game. And for a guy who's the oldest player in the league, he doesn't play like that, he doesn't look like that, and I certainly hope he tries to play in his 42nd year.
Carolina Hurricanes get the zone. Give the puck to the Red Wings, doing it. Cole tried to hit his man and missed him. Up there's Demerol. Caused the problem. Oh, one-timer. Didn't get all of it. Demerol centered it. Nobody in front but red shirts, and they clear it to the line. Brindamore was there. He hooked it out. Pass through center. Coming down as Cole gets the shot. Stop. Rebound. Cleared away by the Red Wings. That was a big rebound off Hasek's right pad. Devereaux is in, swinging sends it back. Shot it back in over the line, and Detroit will be back to pick it up. 9:40 left in the period. The Chelios circles all the way back around the net. Larionov just skating the far side, and Chelios comes to Slager. Larionov went up there, and the pass was just stopped in front of him by Swoboda. Robitaille close to Francis to stick that one. But Wesley comes back in his own zone. Put on the brakes, hurried it up. Knocked down at center ice by the Red Wings. Checking close again now by Carolina. Robitaille back in his own zone. Marianoff dropped it back. Shot away by Duchesne to center. Swoboda stops it, pounds it back in. Wide of the net, Carolina changing. Under 9 minutes left in the first period. Going to the right side and takes the pass. Stopped though, he didn't move a step. Shanahan is over. Kostacek took care of him, but didn't get all of them. And then Shanahan shot it away to center ice. Ward, Kapanen, lifting one in, knocked down. Red Wings will come out with it. Pass, got up off the boards to center by Danilo. Again the try, and Fedorov stopped. Bring it up over the line. Shot in, but nobody getting to it. Hasek is a way out, had to back up. Kapanen picks it up. Comes around the net. He's pushed off the puck, kicked it loose. Kicked it again. Kapanen doing great work along the boards with his skate. Now near the line, he reaches for it. It's knocked down in front of the net. High shot over the goal. And Detroit in a bit of trouble. It's lifted high into the crowd. The Stanley Cup final on Hockey Night in Canada, brought to you by Labatt Blue.
My two great-grandfathers, Henry Ford and Harvey Firestone, used to take these camping trips every year with Thomas Edison and whoever the president at the time was. They sort of invented SUVs. If you want to experience the outdoors, there's no better place in Canada, and there's no better way to do it than in one of our SUVs. We do them better than anybody else. When you get it right, you just know it. Then it's really fun.
One more reason why he's the number one innovator in LASIK surgery and has stepped into the future of laser eye correction. Dr. Tafor at the Windsor Laser Eye Institute now introduces the new LaserVision 4000 Total Eye Tracking System, combining the most experienced eye surgeon with the latest in laser technology. Call Dr. Tafor at the Windsor Laser Eye Institute and restore your vision safely and confidently. The Windsor Laser Eye Institute, focusing on the future and you.
You've probably felt the thrill of anticipation. The dice tumbling down the table. But at Casino Windsor, feel it so much more. With 10 times odds on craps and the currency exchange rate that gives you up to 50% more. Casino Windsor. Absolutely more of what you are looking for.
Carolina created a pretty good scoring opportunity in this rush as Cole will shoot the puck. The Red Wings defensively do a nice job as Datsyuk picks up Wallin's stick as he might have been ready to shovel it in on a fat rebound given up by Hasek.
Sure was a fat rebound, and Wallin was checked just in time. No score, 8:01 left in the first. Control, the face off. Danino fired a hard one, and here's Shanahan picking it up at center. Gets it over the line. He stopped easily, and the play is called. Too many men, I think, by the visitors. It'll be the first power play of the game for Detroit when we come back.
I like to snack. You know, sweet stuff with chocolate, peanuts, and caramel. Sweet. But I also like to be different. Break with tradition. March to my own drum. Which is what Body Smarts does. Body Smarts is a nutritional supplement that's got sweet stuff. Chocolate, peanuts, and caramel. And it's got 24 vitamins and minerals and 6 grams of fat. Body Smarts is different. Different is sweet. Different is delicious. Different is good. Be different. Snack Body Smarts.
Power play for the Red Wings. Penalty called against Carolina. Too many men on the ice at 12:09. Let's see what happens. This crowd is ready to explode. Capacity is over 20,000. Some tickets were on sale this morning if you could manage to get one, and if you had $1,500 per ticket.
The power plays combined 3 for 42. The Red Wings 2 for 21 in this series.
Off the boards, around the net it goes. Detroit up after it. It's cleared where Lidstrom was waiting at the line. Fired in deep by Hull. Robitaille after it, won't get to it. Shot away by Carolina, the length of the ice. 50 seconds gone in this first power play. Lidstrom, right side, fired in by Chelios. Holmstrom is coming up, pushed his man right in front of the net. Cleared to the line and kept in at the line. Holmstrom again, didn't know, nobody was there on that side. And he cleared it himself. Killing some time on his power play. 45 seconds left. Fedorov. Yzerman swinging with him. Fedorov striding over center. Left side. Yzerman will pick it up, but he's offside on that play. And the penalty time is down to 38 seconds.
Too many men on the ice. This is the second time it's happened to Carolina in this series. It's not the coach's fault. It's a guy faking coming off. And here goes one off, and then the guy that was coming on, he doesn't go off and touches the puck. So it was an easy call for the linesman and or the referee.
Power play now for the Red Wings. Puck shot in. 30 seconds left on it. Holmstrom from the corner, coming out. Backed up the puck to the corner again, around the net. Off the boards and back to the blue line. Lidstrom to the other side. No shot. Maybe one here by Lidstrom. No, he's covered now. Gives it to Yzerman. Steve Yzerman steps back a bit. Fires it in. Sharp angle. Centered. Fedorov's shot wide. And missed it. Fedorov behind the net again. Yzerman is out front. Fedorov with the puck to Yzerman. Yzerman gets set to go back for it. Takes the shot right into the midsection of Herbe. As the penalty expires, it's still no score. 5:50 remaining in the first period. The teams are at full strength again.
They're all so beautiful.
Oh, what about that one back there?
Oh, it's stunning.
Could we look at that one, please?
I love it.
How much is it?
It's $1.49.
We'll take two.
There's nothing like fresh strawberries, like the plump red juicy ones on our Tim Hortons strawberry tart. Just $1.49 each. Or try our new strawberry sensation muffin. Which strawberry will you pick?
Gotta be me. Whether I'm right, whether I'm wrong, whether I find a place in this world or never belong, I've got to be me. What else can I be but what I am? I've got to be me.
There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Except that everywhere, dogs are.
Brown makes me a hero. It lets my customers know I've shipped what I promised. It lets them track their own order from the time it's shipped until the moment it arrives. Brown gives me the time to make sales calls instead of tracking packages, which makes me a hero to my boss. Brown works, I get the credit. How terribly, terribly unfair.
Better service, more sales. What can Brown do for you?
That shot from Windsor, Harry, from your hotel room or mine?
Either one, as we see the tall building there, which is the NHL headquarters in Pobu Arena, and then Joe Louis Arena, where we're sitting right now. And people on both sides of the border, Red Wing fans, and looking forward to celebrating tonight.
5:50 left in the first. No score in the first. 7-3 the shots, Detroit. For the Red Wings. Goes after it. Carolina. Rosicek picked it off and got it ahead. Jelinek along the boards. He'll be hit. Malky flipped it behind the net. Ward pinching in. Left the spot wide open, but the Red Wings do not pick it up and cannot move. And now Draper gets a little room to go. Banked it on the boards for McCarty. Tried to hit. Malky, who was going hard. Davis intercepted again and shot back in. Kaplan moved it behind the net. Bastacek nailing Chelios for the hit. Now swinging away. The Red Wings Draper. He got in ahead of the play, though. He was flying, let me tell you. But he gave it to Maltby, and he just kept breezing along, and he was offside.
Well, the Red Wings are playing a little tentatively, I think. I know they'd like to score first, and I know they'd like to put a good show on for these enthusiastic fans who want to see them win the Stanley Cup, but this is the fourth offside on a rush that looked like might amount to something. And the grind line here, Maltby is the man who went offside, with McCarty and Draper have been a factor in many of the wins Detroit has had in these playoffs.
Wallin getting it up to O'Neill. Lifted over the line, not a good play. Myolison and the high shot just missed the top side. O'Neill left it behind the net for Francis to make a play. Francis can't do that. That suit whipped it away from him. He might get it again. He stays right there. Francis got a stick in there. Cuts loose, and Lidstrom is away. Right side pass and back for Lidstrom. Up the center. Beautiful play to get him through the middle. Turn back goal. He gets open and comes after the puck. It's batted away to the line, and it did get out. 4:30 left in the first period. No score. Game five. Wings can win the cup with a victory tonight. Carolina would like a sixth game. If so, it'll be Saturday in Raleigh. Fedorov turning back again. He's done that a lot in this series. The looks of things and just circle back, and now they get it moving. Shanahan fires right on. Stopped by Urban. Good booming shot by Shanahan. Now Battaglia dropped it back, and they get it in deep. A little trouble hanging on to it first, then covered up and helped.
One of the problems Carolina has had in this series that wasn't nearly so obvious in the first three rounds was their inability in this series to recover pucks on shoot-ins. Here's the shot by Shanahan. There was a pretty fat rebound coming off Herbe. And that's against the Leafs, especially in late in the Montreal series. They got to a lot of their own shoot-ins, but this Detroit defense as a group can handle the puck, and they move it past that first forechecker quickly, and the shoot-ins are not recovered very often.
Carolina winning the draw. Ward made a good play to get a puck size. Shot him by heading him around the net. Detroit, Shanahan has it again and gets it ahead. Down to center ice and couldn't knock that down. Aaron Ward again steps up, drops it back, giveaway.
Game point streak going 2 goals, 3 assists. The Carolina used the D to D pass a lot, and here is a careless pass and a careless reception, and Urbe makes a big save on Fedorov to keep this game at nothing, and you can see Fedorov, who I think was trying to go between his legs. Urbe's out, backs in, and Fedorov hits him with the shot.
That's the eighth scoring chance for Detroit in the period. Carolina has had but two, and the shots are 9-4. That was the best chance right there. Notwithstanding, they had a post earlier. Robitaille. Screenshot. Big rebound off that one. Glenn Wesley. Look back to the net. Pass through center, easily stopped by Duchesne, and he rips it back in. There goes Holmstrom. Backhands it behind the net. Carolina with it and coming out. Flip the head along the boards. Kapanen slow moving. Larionov picked his pocket easily. 3:05 left to play in the first period. Larionov, the smoothie. Boy, what a dangerous pass though that was. Kapanen fires. No problem with that. Hasek was out on the edge of his crease. Kapanen had no place to go but fire it right at him.
You don't see Larionov make a backhand pass in his own end as soft as that one to nobody. He may have anticipated Duchesne was there, but he wasn't. And Kapanen, who looked like they had a two-on-one, made the shot from the bad angle. Here is the Fedorov breakaway on the bad pass reception, and you can couldn't see. He was trying to go between the legs of Hervé. And the hole was there, and then it was gone. It always looks like a lousy scoring attempt when you miss going through a guy's leg.
Walling takes the shot. That hit the crowd in front. And it's cleared out by Malpe. Down to center ice, Malpe. Shot it in. Draper was with him. The Draper was bumped trying to go by. Draper now behind the net. Malpe is trying to hook it off and didn't. Apparently can't center it. Draper still fighting for it back there. Twisting and turning against Ron Francis. He gets away with him. And comes out. The pass. Shot! Not a great chance right there for Malpe. Great work by Draper, though, in the corner. 2:20 left. Troy up there again as Malpe. Saw the hit coming by Brindamore. They get the puck out to center ice. Hull was nailed inside the blue line. Now he shoots it in. And here come the Red Wings. Up on the board. That's Devereaux. They get it out to center ice. Carolina moving up. Sharp pass comes off the boards right to Hashik. Taglia takes care of Chelios. Chelios comes around the net to pick it up. Pulled to Taglia. Brindamore there, nearly stopped it. Hull shoveled it ahead, comes back for him. Long pass, Devereaux. In there. Devereaux shot. Stopped by Irving. Off the boards, Carolina. Three of them get going. Two back. So the three-on-two rush comes up. Brindamore's pass. Intercepted. He keeps it in, though. And then he hooked it out. Trying to give it to Wesley. Got it back out over the line. And Hill fires it in. 1:15 left to play in the first period. Still no score. Shot in on the offside. That'll be brought back out. Of course, 11-5 are the shots now in favor of the Red Wings. They are getting chances.
A minute or so ago, the Detroit Red Wings get a chance. Maltby on the side of the net to the right of Hervé will take the pass from Draper, and I think he just shoots it over the net. And the top half of the net was available, but Maltby couldn't get it where he wanted.
She was away on again. Zelenov nearly stole it from. That's a check behind the goal. Up on the boards, in deep again. First period with the Red Wings on the puck in their own zone. Robitaille trying to feed it ahead. Vasilchuk again brings it back in. That's easily cleared to Holmstrom. He stopped. Play stopped. Holmstrom and Kapanen have words.
Well, if you're Paul Maurice trying to figure out who to watch in this Detroit team, it's pretty tough. In the fourth game that they won 3-0, nine different Red Wings had 1 point each. So it's not as if he can concentrate on shutting down one line and improving the chance of scoring. The grind line's got some big goals. We know Yzerman's line has been dynamic. Devereaux's line, I mean, who do you check? Everybody, if you can.
Red Wings win the draw. Shanahan slipped it up the center. That'll be fired back in, and here's Hashik out once more. Shanahan waits for this. Gives it to Fedorov. Down with Yzerman. It's in too far for two of them. And left behind the goal. Carolina coming away. 20 seconds left to the period. Shot in there by Fedorov. Trying to get loose. Yzerman is with him in front of the net. The backhander is stopped. And Yzerman is dumped in front of the net. He's slow getting up. He's all right, though. Back on his skates. Fedorov after it. 4 seconds remaining. Wild swing at it by Chelios. As the horn goes, it's cleared over the glass. And the first period is done. Don Cherry is with us again tonight, of course. And the first intermission will have the coach's corner. 12-5 of the shots for Detroit in that period. But after 20 minutes here in Game 5, Carolina nothing, Detroit nothing. Center, the short pass gets by everybody and dumped into the zone. Draper speeding up. It's up high on the glass. Comes down to Malpe. High again and bounces right down to the line and kept in deep by Olsson. Svoboda. They clear it out. The Francis coming in. Long shot by Ward is high. Kept in on the line. Draper didn't see it and went back there in front of his own net. center ice, but did shoot the puck in as he hit center. Carolina turning with Detroit changing. Rindemore knifes it into the zone and out of the net quickly as Hasek. Slager is hit and knocked down. Long shot knocked down in front of the net. Good chance right there for Carolina. Big rebound. Devereaux is bumped off the puck. Carolina doing some hitting here to start the second period. Shot on the boards. Cole fell but batted the puck out to center ice. He'll have the backup again as Detroit shoot it in. Now to Zurbach. Leaving it there in the corner. Backed up a bit around the net. Going to be kept in though by Duchesne. Fired in around the net. Hull trying to get it loose and did. Back from Devereaux. Duchesne to Chelios moving up. Shot tipped in front of the net. And close to. Chelios fired it up the net. He got it again and shot it there. Carolina now will move it out. Cole down the wing. Got over the line. They're just onside. Rindemore keeps going. Cole turned to go to the bench. So Rindemore was alone in there. They get the puck and a low shot is wide. Kept in though by Malik. His shot missing. Devereaux gets it out down the ice. Racing back Malik. He missed it. Everybody missed it. And cleared away. Down to the right side. Vasicek. Low shot. Big rebound again, but nobody could take advantage of that. And the Red Wings bring it out. Good pace to start the second. 2.5 minutes in. Vasicek again. Move to center. Dump the puck in. Out is Hasek quickly. To the glass with it. Vasicek on the boards. Can't get it. Back out by Dandino. Through center. Fired in by Shanahan. Shanahan gets in there. Had to poke it to the corner. He and Hedekin bump together. Eiserman is bumped. Shanahan centers, turning up the line. Dandino shot. Rebound was there and cleared by Carolina. Vasicek to center. Moving it up at the line. There's onside. Westland shot is wide of the net. That's Daniels going in. Quicker start for Carolina here in the second period. Adams tried a shot. Behind the net. Daniels skated by the puck. Kept in there though. Good work by Carolina. But now the Red Wings get it out. Harmlessly though to center ice. And Hill just had to wait for it. They're turning again. Carolina on the move. Good start in the second period. Shot into the zone. 3:30 gone. Over there is Robitaille. Dumped it back. They get it up the center and Holmstrom. Just waited at the line. Now he cuts in. Gets set for the play. It's off for skate and away wide of the man skating in front of the net, Robitaille. Troy, keep it in. Chelios again. Backed it up at the blue line. Shot is right on by Larionov. Stick save. Red Wings have the rebound and control it. Holmstrom back to the line. Chelios to the corner with it. Larionov center.
The first goal. Now what'll happen? Carolina, I thought, had a good start to the second period and worked the puck in deep well. But Holmstrom diving for the net deflected the puck in. 1-0. Kearney was bumped at center. I think that hurt him. He turns, doesn't go off, lost his glove, stays on. Kearney comes up to say something to Hedekin.
Cole just missed the pass, racing in over the line. McCarty drops it back. This shot stopped. Big rebound again. Cleared away from in front of the net. And Brindamore turns around in front of Urbay. Left wing pass, Malik. The big defenseman gets up. They're offside. If they play it, they don't. Chelios does. So the play allowed to continue. Shot in at the line, and Brindamore will turn back. Hall was forechecking. He had to move it back in front of his own net again. Are catching on, but now it's poked up over the line, just onside. The Taglia shot missed on the short side. Hill tried to drive it. That was wide. The Taglia around the net with Brindamore coming out. He's checked closely. Brindamore shot it back along the boards. Two Carolina Hurricanes are in. And it's Cole who gets it. Out front it goes. Pass off the boards and cleared to the line, but still not out. Brindamore around the net trying to make a play. He leaves it back there. Penalty coming up against Detroit. The six-minute mark. The scoring play was Holmstrom, his eighth of the playoffs, from Larionov and Chelios at 4:07, and now a penalty has been called.
Yuri Slager is going to get it, as he is going to be called for a holding right here, as he's got Cole pinned against the glass for a lot longer than the puck was anywhere near either one of them. And finally, the referee decides Slager is the perpetrator. Let's have another look at the goal here. Chelios keeps it in on the point, and Larionov, as we've seen him so often do, finds Holmstrom, who's got a step on Kevin Adams, and just poke checks it through the legs of Urbay. If you go to the net, and Holmstrom does that as well as any forward in this series, you are often rewarded.
Stabbed the stick down and made contact. Thomas Holmstrom scoring the goal from Larionov and Chelios.
That's his eighth playoff goal in 23 games. He got eight goals in 69 league games.
Now Slager in his first game tonight for the Red Wings. Off for holding at the 6 minute mark of the second period. Power plays, nothing to talk about for either team. Carolina 1-21 in the series. Pass in front to Francis. Back to the line. Up to Francis again. Francis has two to contend with, but they don't get it out. Hill kept it in. Put it in there for Francis. O'Neill fires to Francis again. They're outside, moving around outside. Hill again fires to the corner. Svoboda can't stop it. It'll come to Hedekin. He stabbed at it. And that's it. Shot away down the ice by the Red Wings. Hill slipped, trying to turn around the net to get away from Draper. Now he's okay and gives it to Hedekin. He got center, blasted into the corner. Hasek missed that. Svoboda was out. It gets in front of the net, but slashed away by the Red Wings out of the ice. Chelios just right there at the right time. 55 seconds left of this power play for Carolina. Trailing Detroit 1-0. Shot in. Francis comes up. Pass to Francis. High. Gloved it down. Taglia behind the net. Francis over to help him. Cleared away to the line and kept in for Wesley. He returns it. Hill in deep. Center right in front of the net. Hasek diving. It stays out at the blue line. Wesley had to hurry. He did. Kept it in. One good chance. Henley has 18 seconds left. Hill again. And Wesley once more. Hill's got the good shot if he can get room to shoot it. They don't give him much room because of that. And Brindamore again to the line. Once more, Wesley tries Hill. Shot. That's deflected wide to center. And Hasek stopped it and hauled it back in, but couldn't hold it. Penalty is done. Slager trying to get back there to help. Brindamore centers. Oh, what a chance that was. Hasek lost the stick to boot. Slager drives it on the net. Carolina get it up the center ice, and that's all. Red Wings are flying back. Hold the line. It comes. Three of them centering pass. Off the skate. Here's Robitaille. Just missed the far side. Ducked away.
Detroit.
9 minutes gone in the second. Along the boards, lifted high, and over the boards. At the Carolina bench. Dominator has dominated again. Wow.
Right now, in specially marked cases of Labatt Double Blue, you get 12 blue, 12 blue light, and one Overkill t-shirt.
We'll share it.
One of four Overkill t-shirts in Labatt Double Blue.
Get your own.
Must be legal drinking age. No purchase necessary.
Sign up now for Hotmail Extra Storage. You'll have 10 megabytes of storage, send and receive email attachments as large as 1.5 megabytes, and your account never expires. And from June 6th to the 30th, log on to cbc.ca/worldcup to play Hotmail, shoot, and score for a chance to win $10,000 cash. Just hit the targets in the soccer net before time runs out, and you earn a chance to win $10,000. Hotmail Extra Storage. Live large, share more.
Introducing an all-new Envoy, the XL. Adds a third row that's as comfortable as the front.
It's spectacular. Takes a lovely pass from Brindamore and can't beat Hasek from a perfect scoring position. Hasek, as we've said many times, is tough to beat down low. Spectacular looked like he had him. If he'd have gone upstairs, it might be 1-1.
But it's 1-0 Detroit. What a save, though, with that left skate. Corner of the pad. Beautiful stop by Hasek. He's gone 156 minutes now and a few seconds without allowing a goal to this team. 1-0 Detroit with the goal. Scored here in the second. Holmstrom scored it.
35 of the last 36 penalties Detroit has had to kill off. They've been successful.
Caroline up over center. Sabota trying to catch up. He was hooked a little bit by Datsyuk. In comes O'Neill. Nearly got out front. Datsyuk took care of him. O'Neill goes after Datsyuk. Datsyuk worked it away cleverly and got it out over the line. Hennigan, that's it back in. That's offside. O'Neill was rather Sabota was late coming out.
Dominik Hasek has not been busy, but he's been called upon a few times to make big saves, and he's moving up on maybe, in some people's opinion, the greatest goalie that ever played, Terry Sawchuk. And Frank McCool, the Leaf goalie in the mid-40s, has the record for shutout minutes. This guy could stop the puck.
Yes. Sawchuk. He dared the Red Wings and the old Patsies, the Howe, and Lindsay, Delvecchio, and the like. Jordan practices to beat him. Gordy used to swear it was almost impossible. 9:40 left to play in the second period. Carolina move it up. Brindamore lost it. Cole saw it, and then it was gone. Brindamore in again with it. Centering pass. Tagli dropped it. Brindamore tried to move up, and he was stopped. And it's cleared by Detroit. Hull was up there, couldn't get up there in time to move it. He's slow coming out, but he did get out. And the play is onside. Fired away to this near side. Taglia backing up around the net. They go from side to side and can't get through the Red Wings defense now. And an O'Back. Under 9 minutes left in the second. And an O' drops it. The defense pair bring it up. Shot in from center ice. And here's Draper. Tried to center. Carty went off his glove. Draper again. Kapanen on the boards. Dandenault stopped him. Dandenault pushed it by him. And Malik was there waiting for that and starts back out. Gets it up to Jelena. Carolina to center. Wallin knocked off his stick. took a whack at it, didn't get it in. And cleared back down the ice by the Red Wings. McCarty dumped, heading off to the bench. 8:20 left in the second. Shot 17-6. Only six by Carolina. 1-0, the Red Wings have the goal here in the second. Jelena moved up. Adams just a little late to get a shot. Westland gave it to him. Adams gave it away. And Olsson got to center and shot the puck in for the Red Wings. There's the goal scorer, Holmstrom. Line pass out in front of the net. Nobody moved on it. Easily cleared by Carolina. They keep going. Adams shoots the puck in. We got Hashik. 15 feet out again. Shot it to the boards in the corner. Round the net for the Red Wings. 7:40 remaining. Stopped by Adams, but he's offside himself. Thomas Holmstrom. The goal at 4:07 from Larionov and Chelios. 1-0.
Always one who breaks away. Then it's me against him. He wants to burn me. And there's only one way to fight fire.
It's here, it's clear. New thirst-quenching Gatorade Ice.
Run to Rona for the Father's Day event, June 5th to 16th, and treat your dad to one of two brand new products. Pick up the ultra-practical and ultra-effective Weed Eater Gas Edge Trimmer for only $99. Or, for those handyman dads, Rona is also offering a powerful cordless screwdriver with 19 accessories for an incredible $14.99 after mail-in rebate. Run to Rona for the Father's Day event, June 5th to 16th, at each and every Rona store.
The Dominators got the net boarded up in these finals. Carolina's had about three good chances to score. He can't get it by Mr. Hoffman.
Boy, when he gets in this groove, he is unbeatable, no doubt about that. And he looks to be in a groove tonight. He hasn't been every night. Troy leads 1-0. And under 8 minutes left in the second. Turn pass. Petrov up there and drops it back. Shot right to Erbe. Hold it. And no rebound.
Well, Arthur Erbe, I mean, you can't fault his play in these finals. He hasn't had a chance to play many minutes ahead. And it's an awful big difference when you've got a bit of a cushion. And there are some statistics that show you that both goaltenders have been excellent. Hasek's team gives him a little bit of a cushion to ride in many of the games, but the Carolina team will deny Erbe.
Hedekin jumped behind the net, and then Fanta trying to hit man the puck from his own zone. Eiserman comes up to steal it on the boards. Fedorov was there also. So is Shanahan. He decides to back off, and Brindamore has the puck behind the goal. Tries to skate away. He'll have to go by Eiserman. He does. With Hedekin helping him. On the boards, it goes in deep. Slicker has it. Whipped it right away. Didn't waste any time. And Chelios fires one away. Down the ice it goes. It'll be an icing call, though, as Chelios got a little too much on that. All the way down, and that's icing.
Well, if you are a hockey fan who likes international hockey, how did this guy break our hearts as Canadians? In the Olympics in Nagano, that was Brendan Shanahan, now his teammate, that could not beat Dominic in the Olympics, but Brett Hull in overtime in Buffalo beat him for the big one.
Nobody could beat Hasek in that shootout in Nagano, Japan. Some pretty good shooters, too. He beat them all. Reichel got the only goal. Czechoslovakia, Czech Republic, won it on that shootout. Went on the gold. Penalty coming up. It's against Carolina. On the boards, fight for it. And it looks like Svoboda is going to get the penalty.
This perfect day didn't start at the crack of dawn, nor with the first cast. No, this perfect day...
I got one!
...started a week ago.
Look at this!
...in aisle 35 at Canadian Tire.
This one works.
Hey, Dad, what about this one?
Yeah, I got a good feeling about this one.
Funny how where you end up has a lot to do with where you start. Canadian Tire.
Yaroslav Svoboda with roughing.
He and Draper are fighting for a position here. The puck's in their feet. Svoboda gets carried away and punches Draper in the head and gets a penalty.
So Detroit a chance to go up 2-0. And from what we've seen in this series, the two-goal lead, well, long shot tipped in front of the net. High shot by Yzerman. Fedorov takes it. Successful, as we were saying, against this Red Wing team and getting a little frustrated. I don't know if they called him over there or not. We'll wait and see.
Ooh, yeah.
have so many reasons to arrive that we have been inspired to create so many ways of getting you there. General Motors, getting more people to where they need to be than any company in the world.
I'll be with you guys in a minute.
I noticed you got three X's on your neck. That's appropriate since you're looking at three strikes. Grand Theft Auto, reckless endangerment, and that little bridge stunt of yours. But if you do what I want, I'll make all your criminal transgressions go away.
You get the chance to pay back Uncle Sam for all the freedom you enjoy.
Well, I like this.
Knocked over a few 7-Elevens, have we?
This summer, get ready for a new breed of secret agents.
Wish I had a video camera, because this is going to be one hell of a trick.
Vin Diesel is... Triple X. In theaters everywhere this August.
Closed captioning of this program has been brought to you by the all-new Chevy Avalanche. It's the ultimate utility vehicle.
Called Eric Cole for roughing, but quite honestly, I couldn't see exactly what he did over there.
Maltby crushed him right here, almost from behind. Battaglia really should get the roughing penalty. The referee called it late. He wasn't sure who, but he knew the retaliation penalty or roughing really should have gone to number 13. Carolina coaches are complaining about the misidentifications, but it's going to get them nowhere.
Koscheck has now gone 163 in 31 seconds. He's now number two on the big list of shutout hockey in the finals. He has just passed the great Terry Sawchuk. 3:40 left in the period. Red Wings could just about put the game away right here with a power play goal. Knocked away by Westland down the ice. Immediately, he and Brendan Moore go to the bench. That's a quick penalty kill shift for them. Troy, five people lining up and coming in. Benaroff drops it back to Shanahan. Lost it. Hooked his man down. He's going to get a penalty for that. Shanahan just turned and hooked the guy down. Adams, and he goes for that.
Sure that Adams was had the breakaway that perhaps Shanahan thought he got. After the puck got by Shanahan on the boards right here, and he just turned around and kind of a reactionary hook and pulled him down, and the reaction after the penalty was fairly graphic, I would say. He did not enjoy taking the power play away from his team. And Shanahan had the second goal here in the second period for the Red Wings.
Only 3:07 left in the period. Oh, goals by Holmstrom and to Shanahan. Now Shanahan in for tripping.
Referee McCreary's over talking to the timers bench here. I don't know what the problem is. Play 4-on-4 if there are no further penalties for a minute and 22 seconds when goal gets out. But there seems to be a problem. And perhaps it's with the time clock.
I think so. Curry looking up and appears to be satisfied that the clock is now fixed properly. Showing 1:22 left in the Cole penalty. Shanahan's just starting. 3 minutes left in the second. Now, Hedekin turns back. 2-0 Detroit. Chance here with the 4-on-4 for Carolina. They can never get possession and get something going. They have O'Neill, Kapanen, Hedekin, and Ward. Ward will have to hustle. Hall's coming up behind him. Hall was spun around trying to get in. Carolina will pick it up and skate with it. Aaron Ward gets it over the line. Nice drop pass to Kapanen coming in. Picked it loose. Shot. Right on. Rebound. is unbeatable.
Neat little play by Kapanen. I'm not sure it was accidental or was something he did on purpose when he looked like he lost the puck in his feet. You're going to see right here. Kicks it ahead and then is in a bit of a position to score. Larionov was playing as the defenseman on the 4-on-4 as the Red Wing defenseman Chelios got caught up on the rush. And it ended up being not a bad chance for Kapanen, but another routine save for Mr. Hushin.
Another 42 seconds of 4-on-4 hockey. Then a power play for Carolina when Cole is on. Long shot is blocked easily. That by Wallin. Detroit, three players in. Eisenman headed for the net. That's it back. That one came close. Irving wasn't quite sure where it was. Looked dangerous, but it bounced high. Just missed the net. Crowd roars every time you see the empty net and the puck there. Here's a tip-in attempt by Brindamore. Didn't work. He takes it and gets it back at the line. Long shot. Hasek to save. Huge rebound, though. Carolina's Brindamore trying to take care of that, but it's Fedorov who'll take the puck up to Eiserman. Eiserman plays it through center. Cole is back on the ice, and a power play will be for 35 seconds if they can do something here to stay alive in this game. Cole is racing in. He made a big move going in there, and Hasek came diving out. He lost control of it and went in too far, but boy, did he have a burst of speed. At the line, Wesley keeps it in. Along the boards, that's Cole again. Dumped it away and back to the line. Wesley plays it along the line. O'Neill moves up, slams the shot. That bounced on something up behind him, Hasek, I think, and came back out. Either the post or the crossbar was nailed. So they came close. Close won't count.
A bullet shot by Jeff O'Neill. And I think we have another penalty coming up here. Oh, it may have gone in. That's what they're coming over to check.
Wow. This could be, you know, because I didn't see or hear, really. Let's watch it here, see if we can pick it up. It Jeff did come out.
Oh, I think that hit the middle of the net.
Oh, I think so, too.
Let's look at the overhead. Jeff O'Neill is the shooter from the bad angle on the screen, and it goes on the short side of Hasek. Goes in the net. It is 2-1 Detroit.
Our experts in the truck just outside this big building will have this confirmed before it is really confirmed. Andy Van Hellemund is the supervisor, and there you see Andy with the telephone conversing now with Bill McCrary, the senior official in charge of this game, and it's going to be a goal. Don't worry. Crowd here in Detroit do not know yet.
I'm not sure they know that it was as debatable as it is, because the play went on for a while after. Hasek didn't know where the puck was, but he must have realized it got by him. They are trying to make sure by looking again, but that overhead shot we saw a few seconds ago made it look like it went in, hit the middle of the net.
Yep. I don't know what they're talking about now, but they're looking at every angle. They must have seen what we have seen, and he will point to center ice any second now. Anxious moments for Paul Maurice and Carolina Hurricanes. They're still talking about it, as you can see. And looking at more tapes upstairs, different angles. Here is what we have in our CBC truck. Watch the center of the net. There you go.
The puck was right in, came right around.
It's deep, and it comes off that middle section and back out.
O'Neill will get credit for the goal, I believe. It was not tipped on the way in. There was 3 seconds left in the Shanahan penalty. So when it counts, it will be a power play goal. I don't even think the Carolina players had much of an idea it went in, because there was no immediate complaint like there often is on a goal that is up for review.
In and out so fast, you know, drilled by the goalie. We saw it come back out, and I said it hit something behind Hasek. What? I was not quite sure, obviously. And after the replays over and over, you can be sure now that that is going to be a goal. Well, we're going to try and look at another angle and see what happens.
Here's the shooter, O'Neill, from the bad angle. Maybe they're trying to decide whether Cole kicked it in. That could be the only debate, because the puck's in. Referee's right on the goal line, and it is a goal.
There it is. kicks the side. They are sure now, and so are you, so are we. And it's a 2-1 game with 1:10 left in the second period. So this team from North Carolina will not go away. Jeff O'Neill will get the goal. That's the end of Hasek's shutout hockey at 166-03. We'll get on to something else now.
Well, we know one thing. He's not going to go 163 anymore in this playoff round.
18:50 will be the official time of that goal by Jeff O'Neill, making the score Detroit 2, Carolina 1. So the Red Wings move the puck up and in. Carolina after it quickly. Jelena just flipped it to center ice. We are in the final minute of the second period here in game 5. Olsson, long pass, deflected in over the line by Malpe. Vasilchuk is bumped at center by Draper. Malpe gets it back. Vasilchuk was slow getting up. He stays on, though, so apparently okay. And now the Red Wings up over center. The speedy Draper is in there again. Winds up, shot, blocked. And around the net it goes. 30 seconds left in the period. Vasilchuk slow moving to it. Long shot. Goes in wide. Big rebound out front and Wesley covered for Carolina Hurricanes. Doesn't move it out, though. Jelena is there, hoping to help. Shanahan bumped him. It is cleared out to center ice with 15 seconds left in the period. Boy, turning back. Shot in, could have been offside. It went in deep, will be cleared, so the play is allowed to continue, and that will do it here for the second period. One goes. This is done. The shots are 20 by Detroit over 40 minutes, and 12 by the Hurricanes. 8-7 in that period, Detroit. Three goals scored, two by the Wings, one by the Hurricanes.
So you have to be in a meeting, but you'd rather be whitewater rafting. Why not do both and make a little more free time?
Huge break for the Carolina Hurricanes and Jeff O'Neill's power play goal with just over a minute.
Behind the net, left it there. Surprise move. Boyd able to come up and pick it up. Shot around the net.
Svoboda went over quickly. He fanned on the clearing attempt. Skates around the net. Ward there to his right. Gives it to him. He had no place to go, really, and had to shoot it just out to center. And it's fired back in by Draper. Detroit changing. Carolina move up. They had a good second period. Off pole, down the ice. No icing there for him. And Shanahan deep in his own zone. Knocked down by Cole. Lifted in high. Chelios. He's after it in the corner. Put it up around the boards. Iserman waits. Gives it to Slager. Gives it to Shanahan. Bumped on the boards by Hill trying to go after it. Shanahan took it, only had it briefly, and Brindamore will clear the zone. Nice pass, and then going down across the line, Cole. Went outside, and Slager played him perfectly and nailed him. They're still tangled together as the play goes on. Carolina with the puck around the net. Taglia missed it. Cole comes up, he's bowled over again in there by Slager, who lost the helmet, but Slager stayed right with Cole. Now they continue to push and shove as the play goes on. Down near the line. And through center, Carolina. Dump it in. Back in for Kapanen. He had the chance. It was intercepted just in front of him. Now harmlessly up over the Red Wing blue line. Cross the check for checking. Trying to shoot it from center, Kapanen stopped it. Duchesne feeding it back. Out to Datsyuk. Now Duchesne steps up over center and over the line, winding up, shot, right on, rebound, cleared away. In there was Boyd Devereaux. Carolina giving away by shooting it down the ice. An icing call, nope, they're going to wave that off. Apparently, it was touched to the far side. Allowing Carolina Carolina to make some changes in a hurry. Shot into the zone. Hedekin back. Holmstrom in there. Fast. Tip to the line. Not out. Golfed in wide of the goal. Off the backhand. Holmstrom fell. Out comes Olsson to shoot it around the net again. Holmstrom slammed into the boards back there. He fell in himself, I think. The crowd thought maybe a penalty would come. Nobody moved. Through center. Larionov. Nice pass to Robitaille. In with a shot. Just missed the far corner. He was trying to pick it all right. Troy. In control at the line. Lidstrom. Another defenseman got it up to Larionov. Lidstrom heads off. Robitaille trying to fire it at the net. Got half it. He's going off now. Carolina move up. Pass hopping over the stick. Brindamore, Taglia missed it. Red Wings get it out. Poked over center ice. Hardy has to come up looking for Battaglia. He passed it back. Gets it again. Moved it out fast. Chelios made a good play to get off that line quickly and get in a bit deeper. It's into the crowd over the glass. 3:35 gone in the third. It's still a one-goal game now.
Well, the referees have been pretty liberal. They let Slager get away with an interference call, and they let Hedekin get away with a trip on Holmstrom, who hasn't touched the puck this shift. You know the book on Cole. He loves to go outside. You couldn't get by him with a jackhammer. And then this went on for a long time. The puck's in behind the net. Slager has lost his stick, and watch what he does.
Red Wings. Face off. Won by Carolina. Wesley had to move fast. Kapanen made a dangerous looking pass. Got away with it. Now he's up there to center. Hooked down to his knees. Kept going and flipped it high into the Red Wings zone. Point back. That is Dandino swinging around the net. Flipped it up. Shane got rid of it. Down the ice. Quickly, Draper after him. They get it to the line and out. Good move by Shelanov to get it up over the line. At the blue line, he had to backhand it in around the net. Hasek is out, nearly got caught out. Dandino knew it, had to hurry it. And he did the right thing by shooting it right away down the ice. They do not call icing on this. As we approach the 5-minute mark of the third period, 2-1 Red Wings. Puck to Detroit, Sizer. Fenerov drills it in. They missed that behind the net. Eiserman was up, slashed it behind the goal. Shanahan in. Fedorov is in front. He goes back to the blue line with it. Little backhander in there, tipped off the stick of Eiserman. And he's bumped around a bit. Shanahan back for Fedorov. Missed it. Got out. But Lidstrom covered. Fedorov again. Eiserman waving to the bench. He has to go off. Center O'Neill. He has Hurricanes' goal. This shot from a sharp angle. Hasek made sure. And in there is Svoboda. He's knocked down by Fedorov, and there's going to be a penalty because of that. And he's still down. Here's the call.
Nothing drives a coach insane faster than the non-calls and then a call. I'm not suggesting this wasn't a penalty, but there's been about four of them in this period, and then they grab one out of the hat. Svoboda looks like he's injured. It would look like a cross-check from behind that caused the problem by Fedorov. And then Svoboda goes into the MasterCard sign head first. So Carolina's going to get a power play. Here's the penalty. Cross-checking, I'm sure. Svoboda still has not got up to his feet. He's on his knees, and he's going to go off. But whether it's his head or his back on kind of the whiplash, we don't know.
And he's been one of the good ones, the promising ones for Carolina. They can't afford to lose him. He's been showing some promise in this game. Fedorov cross-checking, you're right, is the call. 5:23 is the time. And now Carolina with a power play.
Svoboda only played 10 league games. He played for Lowell in the American Hockey League and came up and has played in almost all the playoff games. And he's done a nice job. In fact, he's played in every one of them. That's not easy to do. Come up as a rookie after only playing 10 games and earn your spot in the playoffs.
So the faceoff comes inside the Carolina blue line. And Detroit will now have to kill this off. Critical time in the third period of the fifth game. Troy trying to win four in a row, having lost the first of the series. Right here to Carolina. Fighting four behind the goal. Lidstrom to Chelios. Chelios gets lots of time, lots of room. Keeps going with it. The veteran played it back. Lidstrom was there. Just missed being picked off, though, by Cole. Sean Hill turns back. Good penalty killing so far by Detroit. Nice play. That's Draper speeding in. He can fly. He's in there. Shot high. Out it comes. Four Hurricanes are up to center. Cole carries. Gets it in along the boards. O'Neill was bumped. Got back to the line and Hill. Far side broken up. Cleared by Malpe. Not a great pass by Hill. 1 minute gone in the minor. Fedorov. Down through center. They get the zone again. Backed up at the line to Sean Hill. Onside. Crowd thought maybe not. The linesman was right on the line. Here's Larionov. It rolls out over the line. Kick loose. Out there. Hall made a good move. Brett Hall coming in. He waits for help. Finds it in Lidstrom. But he couldn't do anything with it. 30 seconds left to kill. Carolina would love one here to tie the game, and they're coming up after it. They get over the line, but they're offside. This time, 24 seconds left on the power play.
Well, two things kill Carolina's power play in these playoffs. One is they rarely retrieve a puck that's up for grabs. And second, they can't pass the puck well enough to get any kind of momentum over the Red Wing blue line.
Standing, cheering. Goal Wings, 13:01 left, third period.
This is the first time in these playoffs Carolina's in a spot where if they lose the game, they lose the series.
Shanahan, stop that rush. Center in it goes. Ashigan missed it. On the board. Shanahan after it. Carolina. Brindamore in the corner. Penalty is over. Fedorov is on the ice. But they're in deep. Brindamore around the goal. Pass to the boards. Down to the blue line. They feed it in again. Long shot. Tipped in front by Detroit. They don't get it out. Cleared back to the other side. Shanahan racing for Chelios. Falling. Got a stick on it. Offside against the Red Wings. Detroit leads 2-1 in a game where they could win the cup tonight.
Come to Lover's Paradise. Hold hands, skip along the beach, get in touch with love.
You call that a trip? The Ultimate Bud World Experience. That's a trip. Find the winning Ultimate Bud World Experience passport in specially marked cases of Budweiser, and you and three buddies are off to three of these unbelievable sporting weekends. Must be at least 21 years of age, no purchase necessary.
One more reason why he's the number one innovator in LASIK surgery and has stepped into the future of laser eye correction. Dr. Tafor at the Windsor Laser Eye Institute now introduces the new LaterVision 4000 Total Eye Tracking System, combining the most experienced eye surgeon with the latest in laser technology. Call Dr. Tafor at the Windsor Laser Eye Institute and restore your vision safely and confidently. The Windsor Laser Eye Institute, focusing on the future and you.
We can't grow hair on a billiard ball, but we can make baldness a thing of the past. I'm Dr. Christopher Cole. If hair loss bothers you, investigate my micro and mini grafting technique, your own perfectly natural-looking growing hair. Look good and feel great. Wash it, cut it, permit dye it, style your restored hair any way you want.
Take advantage of the favorable U.S. exchange rate, just 20 minutes from the bridge or tunnel. For your personal consultation, call Dr. Cole.
Bowman, 12 minutes and 16 seconds away from adding another collection to his trophy case in East Amherst, New York. Paul Maurice trying to avoid that.
Scotty hasn't changed expression for 2 minutes.
2 months, maybe.
2 years. Red Wings win the draw. Red Wings lead 2-1. Carolina stays in the game, in the thick of things. Out to Kapanen into center ice, drills it in. He was hit, backed up, shot down the ice. Draper again was speeding up and nearly got a break. Crowd wants one more goal. Of course, Claire hurt.
Vasilchuk is going to get a penalty, and boy, these are the kind that kill you when you're in this position. It's a retaliation penalty. Maltby ball. Watch Maltby right here. He throws the hit on Vasilchuk. Vasilchuk now comes back and spears him in the groin.
Why would he do that in a one-goal game?
Only he knows. We've given lots of compliments to this young man, but you have to control your temper under these circumstances. Even if they kill it off, Bob, they waste 2 minutes. They might have been able to get back and get a scoring chance or two.
Well, Detroit, you can bet your bottom dollar will pull out all the stops now to get one more. They're leading 2-1. Larry Onov on the ice, the master quarterback throughout his career. He's on the move for Lidstrom to come up and try to hit him with it, but it was blocked. Brindamore races back. He lost it to Larry Onov, and here he comes again. Larry Onov up over the line. Beautiful play to drop it back to Hull. Shot doesn't reach the net from Olofsson. And Carolina will drill it down to Hasek, and he had a problem with that one. Got the inside of his pad. A shot from a sharp angle in the corner by Brindamore. He had to be careful with. Lidstrom this time drills it to the left of the goal. Comes around swiftly to this near side. Daniels poked at it. Troy trying to cause something here, but it's out and down the ice again. 1 minute gone in that penalty to Carolina's Vasilchuk. Petrov starting to move over there and gets a pass. Dropped it back. That won't work. Shanahan drops it deeper again. Turning is Iserman. Back to Iserman. A little bit of room for him to get the zone. Shot it in okay. Hedekin fired it. Round the net. Ward couldn't move it out first time. It's kept in. Shanahan. Save on that shot by Shanahan, and everybody knows he can shoot him.
Boy, the ability to ice the puck. Aaron Ward had a great chance to get it out of the zone all the way down the rink, and he couldn't do it as it was picked off. Not Aaron Ward, sorry, Kevin Adams. And it was picked off by Lidstrom, and a scoring chance result. You have to get it out, killing a penalty when you get your stick on it. Iserman goes to the front of the net. Sniffing around for a little bit of a rebound, and his former teammate Aaron Ward knocks him to the ice.
23 seconds, that's all that they have to kill now. And Hill gets a chance to rattle it hard. He made no mistake, just turned and knew where the opening was.
It's a talent. Talent good penalty-killing defenseman have.
That was Sean Hill, number 22. 8 seconds left, that's all, on this power play. You hear Hasek stick up there at the other end, telling everybody, watch it. The penalty is over. Vasilchuk is on the ice. Flipped around the net. Brindamore doesn't reach for it. Datsyuk shot it in. Back for Datsyuk. He's going to stick handle some more. And around to him now. left in the third period of game five. Hall out there. Little dump pass in front of the net. Right to the goalie. And Urbe will hang on to this. The Stanley Cup final on Hockey Night in Canada. Brought to you by Labatt Blue.
What I'm about to tell you cannot leave this room. Tomorrow, discover the secret.
The Corps developed a new code based on the Navajo language
that changed the course of history. Wind Talkers is as exciting as movie making gets. Rafe's premier magazine.
He's my responsibility.
Come on!
Nicolas Cage.
You done good today, man.
You never called me that before.
Wind Talkers starts tomorrow with theaters everywhere.
What if General Motors hadn't introduced the airbag? Or safety glass in all windows? What if GM hadn't invented the side door beam? Or the modern crash test dummy? What if GM hadn't invented today's concrete highway divider? Would you still feel safe getting into a car? As the world's largest automobile maker, we're not only committed to improving our cars, we're committed to improving all cars.
I like to snack. You know, sweet stuff with chocolate, peanuts, and caramel. Sweet. But I also like to be different. Break with tradition. March to my own drum. Which is what Body Smarts does. Body Smarts is a nutritional supplement that's got sweet stuff. Chocolate, peanuts, and caramel. And it's got 24 vitamins and minerals and 6 grams of fat. Body Smarts is different. Different is sweet. Different is delicious. Different is good. Be different. Snack Body Smarts.
Kenny Holland, the general manager of the Wings, count the seconds.
Detroit line up inside that blue line for this draw. 9:19 left in regulation time. Red Wings 2, Hurricanes 1. Carolina's Hennigan wrapped it hard. Cole can't pick it up. He'll have another faceoff in his own.
Owner of the Carolina Hurricanes. The seconds are going faster for him than they are for Kenny Holland. And Mr. Illich wants to see his franchise under his direction win their third Stanley Cup.
They have a leg up on it now, winning 3 straight after dropping the first game in the series right here at the Joe Louis Arena. And they're ahead by 1 goal. Reaching for that. Got it up near the line, and Francis made a good play there in the zone. Flying in was Hennigan, but didn't control it. They keep it in, right in front of the net, pass through the crease. Ward pitching in, O'Neill behind the goal, centering it. It's picked off in front by Detroit, and shot away. Malpe made that interception and cleared it. And he was drilled just as he cleared it. Malpe now, hit again, trying to move the puck. To Chelios. He drops it back. Both teams changing. Schlager backhands it ahead. That hits somebody and went over the boards at the far side, I guess. We can look now to see the big, valuable case just came into the building. The cup all shiny and ready to go. Maybe tonight, just maybe.
Oh, yes.
Well, it's as often as not, they bring it in and don't present it the first time they bring it into the rink in the final.
H-10 is what's left in the third period. Carolina playing better since the first. Shots are 22-15 now over 2 periods and 12 minutes of this third. Iserman, the captain, got up, slipped at the blue line, but did manage to get it in deep. Iserman takes it again, backs it off. The shot by Schlager is blocked. Snot out, kept in. Detroit, Iserman! Right on. Loose puck in the side of the net. They're still after it. Cleared off the boards and out. Urbe had lost his stick. They nearly got what they wanted. Some insurance. Once again, it was Angerman who created that chance. Larionov, a trying to get that one goal that they think will do it. Offside, Robitaille, slow coming out because he was hit. And the Red Wings come close again. Hervé is looking sharp now.
Well, his job is not to give the Red Wings the next goal. Here's why you'd like to play on the wing with Yzerman, or with Larionov. Go to the net with your stick down, and you'll probably be rewarded with the puck. Holmstrom could not beat him. And Fedorov lets one go there that sneaks in behind Hervé. And then Wesley, he can't find it with a stick or his glove. And the Carolina Hurricanes get away with two, because with 6:55 to go, if the Wings go up by two, this baby is over.
.655 remaining in regulation time. Carolina trying to hang on here, get a goal, and see what happens. Force a game six back in Raleigh. If that's the case, it'll be Saturday. Look at that lead pass. Too far, not much far, though. Well, he didn't like that. McCurdy was knocked down, lost the helmet, and he's furious. But it doesn't matter. Carolina moving up. Cole drills the high one. That's off the glass. Cole around the net. Pinned in there by Olsson. McCurdy still has his back on the long shot. That was close. Hasek got his glove up. And he has been bothered with somebody in the crease area. Red Wings move out. Malkin. Down with McCurdy. That's too far for him. And Hedigan is back. Down to Aaron Moore. Can he get to center? Just barely, and gets it up over the line. Kapanen saw the hit from Chelios coming and backed off. Chelios gets a stride or two going. Nice lead pass for Datsyuk. Just off the end of the stick. Sean Hill has to hurry it. He does. Kapanen touched it out. Rink-wide pass is good. Brindamore comes up on the play. It doesn't come back to him. But now he takes it on the boards in the corner. Kapanen went by. Two-on-one shaping up. No, only Holland, and he dropped it to open ice. Under 6 minutes left in regulation. Into Hasek. He'll hang on. It's anybody's game. This game five.
Right now, in specially marked cases of Labatt Double Blue, you get 12 blue, 12 blue light, and one Overkill t-shirt.
We'll share it.
One of four Overkill t-shirts in Labatt Double Blue.
Get your own.
Must be legal drinking age. No purchase necessary.
If you happen to see even more people in Moores these days, it's because right now, we're having our summer sale. Which means you'll find suits starting at $130, sport coats at $100, as well as casual wear, slacks, shoes, and outerwear at big savings. After all, while there may be a lot of places having sales this summer, we think you'll find what we have to offer will suit you the best. Well made, well priced, well dressed. Moores.
There's always one who breaks away. Then it's me against him. He wants to burn me. And there's only one way to fight fire.
It's here, it's clear. New thirst-quenching Gatorade Ice.
Listen to this bunch. Over 20,000 standing, roaring, 5:24 left. Is it Cup Night in Detroit? Francis mishandled at the blue line. Center. Under 5 minutes left to play in regulation. Hasek out. instructions to his defenseman to move it. It's shot in wide of the net. Hasek diving, got a piece of it. Carolina forcing the play in there. And it's shot back down the ice. And Irby had to leave the net. Did make the right move. And cleared it away.
Is there a penalty for the goaltender shooting it over the glass, or did it deflect off somebody over the glass? It doesn't appear that the referees are going to give the penalty, so it must have gone off somebody. Detroit's complaining. Here it is right here. Well, it would have been an awful time to take this penalty. Pretty tough to tell there whether it went off somebody, but the referee said it did.
I don't think it did either.
Let's have a look. Boy, oh boy, they got away with this.
Boy, that's a tough penalty anyway, you know, whatever you call it. But in a game like this, in the third period, 4:43 left in the fifth game, with a cup on the line, and the Red Wings lead by a goal, 2-1. Irby got away with one.
What a killer that would have been.
Well, Carolina is still alive. By a thread, to mind you. 4:43 left. Shots are getting to the even point. 24 Detroit, 17 Carolina. They're giving it a good go here tonight. Draper gets it back. Slater ripped it right on. Big rebound off Irby. But it was clear. Carolina, they didn't know they had knocked it over the line. And Detroit will move it back out. 4:30 to play. In regulation, Hill ahead to the line. They get to the line, and in deep from Svoboda. Vasilchuk comes up with Zelena. Svoboda turns all the way back, tried a shot. He's going to get the puck again. Drives it up the net. The big crowd was there, too. But it was cleared out by the Red Wings down the ice. Irby is away out of the net, 30 feet. Detroit is changing. Carolina will move in a hurry. Here they come. Three of them are speeding away. They get the zone. Brenda Moore working hard to the net. Can't get a stick on it when he was checked in front of the goal. Detroit trying to move it out. They do. One man back for Lariano. Holmstrom is with him. Lariano! Holmstrom! He didn't get a shot to talk about. And it's cleared away. Lariano set him up. But he barely got a stick on it. 3:30 left. Exciting now, folks. Detroit fans are standing. 2-1, Detroit. A win, and they got the cup. Federal shoot, stop by Irby. Puck is still in there. Detroit looking for that one goal. That will do it. They fail. On the board, centering pass. Picked off by Brenda Moore. Heading coming around the net. Coming away. Lead pass of beauty up to O'Neill. O'Neill chopped it over the line. Side and nailed by Chelios. Yzerman takes the puck in his own zone, gets it ahead, and stopped at the line by Wallin and kept in under 3 minutes left in regulation. Carolina going hard after it. At the line is Alphys sticking out. Sean Hill backing up with 2:40 left. Through center. In over the line, Carolina broken up. The chant is we want the cup. Soon it'll be, maybe, we have the puck and they can hang on for another 2:24. Puck handed to Carolina. They're coming on hard. The puck is up to the Detroit line. Zelena's pass. That was Svoboda behind him. He didn't see him. And it's called on the offside.
Well, the Red Wings had a couple of great chances to score. Fedorov here with a good shot off the right shoulder. And then the two-on-one rush where Holmstrom can't control the puck. Talked to Scotty Bowman this morning, and I'm going to tell you this. Take a good look at this guy. I think it's his last game.
Well, the thing is, probably has his mind made up what to do after the season's over, but there might be something left in the season yet. The way Carolina is coming on here. 2:05 left, and they're getting some puck control up there. The
Battaglia was grabbed from behind. Pitching in on this near side is Malik. But he's a lumbering, skating defenseman and couldn't move up there in a hurry. It is kept in, though, but now it's out. 1:50 remaining. Watch Hervé. He'll go if they get control up another time inside that Detroit line. Fired in from center. That is onside. Hervé not moving in. 1:40 left. Larionov, the smoothie. Shot it down the ice. Good thing Hervé did stay in. It was right on the net. Cleared by the goalie. The Hedekin can't move it out. Robitaille nailed. He had Larionov open in front of the goal, too. Hill nearly lost it to Larionov. 1:20 left. Is the cup to be presented tonight? The crowd is deafening now. Red Wings get it to the line. One goal will do it. It's Hull centering it. Up there. Robitaille shot it behind the goal. 1 minute left to play. In regulation time. There goes Artur Zerbe. Here come the Hurricanes. The shot is deflected wide of the net. Cleared up on the boards. Dumped away to the line. There goes Shanahan. Empty net. Scores! His first Stanley Cup. This is thunderous here in Detroit. Hockey Town, USA.
Have another look at the goal here. Some good work by Detroit to get the puck out on the board. They've done it so many times in this playoff. The Carolina Hurricanes are complaining that the puck hit a Red Wing on the bench after it was chipped off the glass to Shanahan. Win the argument, and the Detroit Red Wings are right there ready to do it, Bob.
Scotty Bowman is going to set another record in just a minute, 44.5 seconds, 9 Stanley Cups. He shares the record with Toll Blake. Scotty says, don't ever compare me with Toll Blake. He was the very best. He won his 8 cups in just 13 seasons. This is my 32nd, Bob. Tonight is Scotty's 36th finals win, another record. I say to you, William Scott Bowman, take a bow, Scotty. Your numbers, they stand forever.
If it is true that he's hanging them up, what a great time to do it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Down the ice, and Hervé is back in goal. Valiant effort by the Carolina Hurricanes. No question about it. Into 4 rounds. There goes Hervé again. They're not going to quit. They'll keep doing something, try to get something going. Only 20 seconds left in which to do it. You can't do that, guys. That is just too much. 12 seconds. I'll let them count you down to another Stanley Cup for Detroit. 2002. Yes, sir.
Shoot one in the net.
The Stanley Cup will be carried out onto the ice. And look at this. Is this a scene or what? Hockey Town, USA. Olsson. Datsyuk. Robitaille. And Hasek. Brand new Stanley Cup names.
Skill and confidence are an unconquered army. The Detroit Red Wings have both.
This visit with Brendan Shanahan.
Right, Bob Cole. Here is Brendan Shanahan. Two goals tonight. It's so hard to get. What was the measure of this team and this championship, Brendan?
Just teamwork, sticking together. People said all year long we run out of gas at this time of year, that there weren't enough pucks to go around for all the shooters, but we didn't care who scored. We didn't care who was the star that night. A different guy stepped up every night, and our depth prevailed.
You've been here before, but you incorporated new people into this team. Brett Hull, Dominic Hasek, Luke Robitaille, Fred Olsson. What did they mean in the end?
They're just, they were inspirational for us. A guy like Luke Robitaille, he came here coming from playing 23, 24 minutes a game to playing 12, 14 on some nights. Positive all year long. Scored some key goals for us in the playoffs. It was awesome. We gotta get back over there.
Good luck, Brendan. Thank you.
Shanahan got the goal, his eighth of the playoffs in 1915. That salted this thing away. And who do you think got the puck up to Brendan Shanahan for that break at the empty net? Steve Yzerman. And here comes the coach with the skates.
I think Walt Whitman had it best regarding Yzerman when he said, "Oh, captain, my captain, our fearful trip is done. The ship has weathered every wreck. The prize we saw has won."
Number nine for Scotty. We've already mentioned that. He set a record for most wins in the Stanley Cup. Playoff. Most cups now by a coach. Passing his hero, Toll Blake. Hasek gets his trophy.
Scotty.
Here's Scott.
Oh, Scotty's just on his way over here. Scotty, real quick. Congratulations, Scott. Nine Stanley Cups, but what are you thinking about most right now?
Oh, what a win. That's the most I'm thinking about. For the guys that didn't win, you know, before. Thanks.
I know. Are you going to come back, Scotty?
We're going to talk about it after.
Guys, there you go.
After the British Open. He's going to Muirfield. I told you that the other night. And that's all he could think about that afternoon. He's got a great trip coming up for the British Open.
When he brings the cup to East Amherst, all the members of the Transit Valley Golf Club get a tee time so they can pass his backyard on the sixth hole, veer off the course, get their picture with the cup, play the rest of the golf game.
And that'll happen again.
Yes, it will.
As Harry mentions, he lives close to Scotty at East Amherst, New York, right on the golf course. Your game hasn't improved all that much, though.
He still beats me. Got the touch around the green.
He's a legend, and no doubt about it. Hasek, world championships, gold medals. Now, a Stanley Cup.
Nick Lidstrom, third Stanley Cup. Congratulations. What are you thinking about in terms of how this victory was made?
I thought we had four solid lines going for us. We had good balance on our lines, and Dom played great for us back there.
You partnered with Frederik Olsson for a while, a guy who had not won a Stanley Cup through many years. Your thoughts about him and how you worked together?
It's been great playing with Freddie. He's really easy to play with. He's really helped me out making the first outlet pass, and it's just great for him to finally hoist the cup.
Thank you. Good luck, Nick.
Thank you, Scott.
Over to Scott Oak.
All right, here's Paul Maurice. Paul, great run by the Carolina Hurricanes. How are you going to look back on it?
Well, I think we'll take some time. Thanks, Luke. We'll take some time and feel the pain for a little bit while, but still too early, you know. You don't get to this point unless you really believe you can win, which makes it quite a bit more painful when you don't.
You think the Carolina Hurricanes have established themselves as one of the NHL's elite?
For the this year, and we start it all again in September.
Thank you, Paul. Congratulations.
A hearty congratulations, Paul Maurice. Any moment now, we'll hear the announcement as to who has won the Conn Smythe Trophy as the most valuable player in the Stanley Cup playoffs of 2002.
Vladimir Konstantinov, struggling to get out on the ice, watches every warm-up from the Detroit bench. The players greet him on the way out and greet him on the way in.
Here again, let's visit with Scotty Bowman.
Thanks very much, Bob, and I know you and Harry were talking about Scotty. You said something to me just a moment ago, Scotty. What's up?
Well, it's my last game as a coach. I've been thinking about it. I made up my mind on the break, at the Olympic break. We got lucky again. I had a little bit of a rest, but I'm happy to go out now.
People are so happy, and yet they will be disappointed and miss you. What will you think about in terms of this night and where it might fit in all those great victories, Scotty?
Well, I got two people, many people to thank, but the first person I have to thank, obviously, is my wife, who stood right beside me for the last 30-plus years. And I'd like to say a special thank you to Sam Pollock, because 46 years ago, he gave me my first job in hockey, going to Ottawa. So thanks very much, Sam.
Thank you very much, Scotty, and best to you.
Thank you.
Guys.
What will Scotty do now? He's a hockey man through and through.
He has a contract to be a consultant with the Detroit Red Wings, he told me, for 3 more years. So he said, I'll be going to games, but I don't have to win them.
Oh, yeah. Quite a story. Scotty Bowman, winning as coach, adding another Stanley Cup tonight here in Detroit. Red Wings win the series in 5 games with a 3-1 victory tonight over the Carolina Hurricanes. Soon we'll hear the announcement of the Conn Smythe Trophy winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome National Hockey League Commissioner Gary Bettman to present the Conn Smythe Trophy to the 2002 Stanley Cup Playoff Most Valuable Player.
I come bearing gifts. The first one is the Conn Smythe Trophy, and it is awarded to Nicholas Lidstrom.
To see a defenseman be recognized for this trophy.
The crowd is just settling into that announcement now. They are waiting with bated breath, and you know they were thinking of, well, we'll let that be now. But when he said Nicholas Lidstrom, it was a moment of gathering together, and then they all stood and roared, and are still applauding. That's a great, great decision.
The Atlantic Ocean isn't nearly as wide as it used to be. This is the first European to win the Conn Smythe Trophy.
Once again, here's Scott Oak.
Bob, thanks very much. It was 20 years ago that Mike Ilitch bought the Detroit Red Wings, and boy, you've spent a fortune on the team since. How does that investment seem tonight?
Seems like a real smart investment, but I tell you what, we had some great leadership from Steve Yzerman. We had 5 or 6 players could have been captain of our team. They set their egos aside and made up their mind and wanted to go after the cup. And I was just very, very happy to have team play. You know, I'm really excited about it. It was great. It was a great, great victory.
Mr. Ilitch, your reaction to Scotty Bowman's announcement? I don't know if you've heard it, but he has announced that he's retiring. He's coached his last game.
I know. He just had a big hug, and he whispered in my ear. He said, it's time, Mike. I got to go. So I said, Scotty, thank you so much for the 3 Stanley Cups. I'm indebted to you for life.
Thank you, Mr. Ilitch. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So it's official now. He's told us, and he's told the owner.
And I think his team knows, and they didn't.
Yeah. They could have chosen Yzerman. They could have chosen Hasek. They chose Nicklas Lidström, and everybody is happy with that. Oh, yes. Great choice.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup!
In 6 years, and great fans. That's why Detroit is Hockey Town. Let's first congratulate the Carolina Hurricanes on a great season and for their great fans in the Carolinas. Tonight is because Mike and Marian Ilitch have a passion for the game, a passion for Detroit, and a passion for the Red Wings. Congratulations to them. Jim Devolano and Ken Holland put it all together. Scotty Bowman is the coach by which all other coaches are measured. And when you look at these great players, the first reaction is, let's give them the keys to the Hall of Fame. But not tonight. Tonight they are in the Stanley Cup. Steve Yzerman, come get it.
Sometime. You've got to hand it to this man, no doubt about it. And Hasek gets his first Stanley Cup with the help of Yzerman and all these Red Wings. Well, this is quite a scene with Hasek finally holding this cup.
What a double-barrel shotgun it would be if Hasek says he's not coming back.
Robitaille, first time. Luke Robitaille, prolific scorer in the National Hockey League, holding the cup for the first time. They all tell you, I've always dreamed of holding this cup. I wonder what it's like. And here's another first-time guy, Steve Duchesne. Now you know what it's like, Steve. It must be a great feeling.
Steve Yzerman has orchestrated this to have players, those ones that have not won the cup but have played a pile of hockey, after Scotty Bowman grabbed it, they get it first.
Olsson is the other who has not won a cup till tonight. Look at this. The veteran Chelios. You keep talking about veterans with this team. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. talk about veterans. Look at this.
What a thrill for this guy. One game, name on the cup, gets a chance to hoist it over his head. Played a lot, played well tonight.
Darn right he played well. Gary Slager, Harry is talking about. Had to come in. When Fisher had to serve a game suspension. And Fisher gets his shot. Preston all.
Can number the lines 1-4. He nearly couldn't play after a very severe concussion. The Red Wings took a chance on him and signed him as a free agent.
Andino was a winger. Scotty said, you can play defense and we're going to help you do it. Brother, has he turned out to be great back there? Let's visit with Scott Oak again.
Bob, thanks very much. Here's what. Okay, Bob, thanks very much. Here's one of the architects of the Stanley Cup, Kenny Holland. Kenny, 8 regulars, 35 years of age or older, but in the end, was age an advantage?
Well, I don't know. It was an incredible journey. We had so many people step up at different times. Game 7 against Colorado, Luke Robitaille, I was just telling him, never forget the first period, Dominic Hasek throughout. But I think that we had a lot of guys that wanted it so bad.
And they got it. Thank you, Kenny.
What?
And said, and they got it.
Yeah, we're absolutely thrilled. It's been an incredible two-month run.
Okay, here's Scott Russell with Steve Yzerman. Scott.
Thank you, Scott. Here is the captain of the Red Wings. This victory was hard won, even though it may have been expected in some ways. Can you reflect on it now?
Well, you know, I thought our team got better with each round of the playoffs. We won this series in 5, but Carolina forced us to play our best, and we really responded, played really well, and we really had to earn it. You know, it's really gratifying because we battled hard. We're able to beat a tremendous Colorado team in a tough Game 6 and come back and beat them in Game 7. Our team really worked hard, and you know, I think this might be the most satisfying of the 3 Stanley Cups we won.
You know, Steve, I want Mark, our camera, to show your daughter, Isabella, who is here. Generations of hockey people. From her, you go right to a mentor for you, Scotty Bowman, who told us tonight, that's my last game. I'm finished, and what a way to go. Can you think about that?
Well, he said that to me after the game ended right away, and all I can think of is what a tremendous job he's done with our team. He turned our organization around, and he taught everybody what's important, what you have to do to win. You know, there's no way we'd be here. We wouldn't have 3 Stanley Cups without him. He turned it all around for us, and he kept us going, kept us motivated. He's just been tremendous.
One of the wonderful things about the Wings, Steve, is each year it seems you accept different and great players into your lineup. Brett Hull comes back here. Dominic Hasek, Luke Robitaille, guys who have not won as many Cups. They have been important, haven't they?
Absolutely. Everybody at some point, at some game in each series, everybody stepped up with a big game or a big play in a certain game. Just a tremendous team effort. And that is derived from Scotty's attitude. It's the only thing that matters is winning, and the only thing that matters is a team. So you have to find a way to be effective, find a way to contribute, and everybody does that.
Steve, I hope you enjoy this victory very much. Good luck to you and your family.
Scott. Thank you very much.
They're all getting their turns, carrying the cup, and here's Fedorov getting a great cheer from this crowd.
Red Wings are so organized, Bob. They've got this part of the Stanley Cup celebrations orchestrated. And let me give the NHL a gigantic plug for keeping the cameraman off the ice so everybody could share this moment.
Just about everybody has carried the cup now, and there's Konstantinov being presented the cup by Fedorov. He's pointing to the great defenseman with the Detroit Red Wings, who we might happily report, that he's better now. Not quite all the way, of course, but he knows what it's all about. He can't speak to you now. He comes to the games. He greets the players as they leave the ice after the warm-up. And look what he's going to do now. He's going to lift the Stanley Cup again like he did before. I told you he was better. Look at this. This crowd is something else, too. They stayed here, over 20,000, have not moved, won't miss a trick, and they're standing all the way through this.
The Black Aces, Bob, are out there, the players that have practiced for 8 weeks, and many of them not get into a game, are dressed in their uniforms and are out on the ice. And you saw Bowman, he's going around saying to them, you were a vital part of this victory. Even though you didn't play, we knew we could go to you. And Slager proved it tonight.
Scott Russell.
Thank you, Bob. Luke Robitaille, 16 years in this league, 600 and more goals, 150 playoff games and more, and now the Stanley Cup. Can you reflect on that?
I don't even know what to say. I mean, played my whole life, you know, my whole career. That's what we play for, and I don't even know what to say. It feels so good.
You came to a team that had so many great stars, Steve Yzerman and Hasek in the net, and Brett Hull was there, Brendan Shanahan. What has it been like for you, a star in your own right, to play in this group?
It's been like a dream. I mean, you know, every time you go on the ice, you got a chance to make a great play or scoring chance, but the fact that everybody set the same goal just to win as a team, it's been the best feeling. I mean, there was no individual on our team, and that's why we won. And what a great feeling when you play with so many stars and everybody played towards the same goal. It's just unbelievable.
Luke, I saw your wife Stacia in the crowd tonight, and your two children. Do you think of them at a time like this, and what have they given to you?
Well, it was a huge sacrifice this year. We split apart, you know, they did like a lot of mileage. They came every week or every 2 weeks, and it was tough on their school and so forth. And what a great feeling it is to finally do it. I mean, we did a sacrifice as a family.
All right, you got a team picture again. Good luck, Luke.
Yes, they've just called the photographer out, and this is the last organized thing to be done on the ice tonight here at the Joe Louis Arena. The picture. We don't have to say anything else, just that it's the picture.
Finally, the Stanley Cup. Your thoughts about this great victory tonight?
First of all, you know, thanks, you know, to the Detroit. I could come here, you know, and make this journey come true. It's just my dream came true. And I tell you one thing, I never seen more excited building like here, this building tonight. It was something I couldn't even imagine. It's a fantastic feeling, and I'm so happy.
You had said before that, yes, I had an Olympic gold medal. I've got the 6 Vezina trophies. But was this perhaps the most important thing?
It was my, exactly, after winning so many individual trophies, you know, I never won this team trophy, and I was, what can I say, it was a dream, you know, and but you know what, to play for Stanley Cup is 2 long months, you know, you are up and down, you were through the injuries, and all of a sudden it came to the last game, and we won the last game, and I'm so happy, you know, for everyone here.
What was it like for you to come to such a wonderful group of hockey players? Brett Hull, Brendan Shanahan, Steve Yzerman, the list goes on and on.
Yeah, and coaches and all the whole organization. I mean, you know what? It was better than I expected, you know. I mean, the great regular season, you know, we worked so hard to be in the first place, so to have the home ice advantage. And we use it against Colorado in the semifinals, you know, and we did our job in the final, you know, and there's no better feeling than, I am telling you, you know, to raise this Stanley Cup.
I know you've worked so hard.
But would you like to come back?
Tough question. You know, for me, 3-4 days, you know, to meet my wife, you know. I'm so happy she's here with me, and my son could see it, you know, it was his dream too, you know. You know, I were for a long time, you know, twice I was so close, but finally I made it, you know, and we made it, I'm so happy.
Enjoy, Dominic.
Thank you.
Somebody mentioned to Sergei Fedorov the other day, what do you think? Would Dominic Hasek come back for another season? And Fedorov said, forget about it. He'll be back. He's a great goalie. He's proved that so many times. And now the Stanley Cup. Number 10 for the Detroit Red Wings. Montreal is 23, Toronto 13. The Red Wings are coming on. This is number 10 tonight.
The Stanley Cup Playoffs on Hockey Night in Canada. Brought to you by Labatt Blue, official sponsor of the Stanley Cup Playoffs.